So, good morning to everybody. Thank you for the organizer for inviting me and giving me the possibility to speak about the strategy, policies, but also practical instruments and practical tools developed by the ministry. First of all, I would like to say that I would like to introduce myself because I represent the ministry and give you the greetings from our Secretary General, Antonia Pasquarecchia, who in this moment is deeply involved in institutional tasks and works. These days are for us important days. I'm director of Central Institute for the Union Catalogue of the Italian Libraries, which is a central institute of the Ministry for Cultural Heritage. This institute deals with the main activities, the managing of the Union Catalogue of the Italian Libraries. We have we manage a network of 5,000 Italian libraries with a big Union Catalogue containing more than 12 million of records. But the Institute is also deeply involved in digital cultural heritage, in digitization of cultural heritage, not only for libraries, but for all the sectors of cultural heritage. The summary of my presentation, I will be short. MIBAC policy for digital cultural heritage, what is Cultura Italia, Musei d'Italia, a portal for Italian museums, and practical tools developed to help museums, to help institutions in giving visibility on the web. C'è Content Management System Museum Web. Museum in the Web is the name, in fact, of this instrument. Movio, a tool for digital exhibitions, and some words about European projects in the field of digital cultural heritage managed or participated by the Institute. And finally, I would like to present you a strategy of the next Italian-European Union presidency and events organized for the Italian presidency. You know that the second semester of 2014 is the turn of Italy to hold the presidency of the European Union. I would like in one slide to present the Ministry for Cultural Heritage in Italy, the Ministry for Cultural Heritage, Activities and Tourism is a big institution. You can see on the top of the Ministry we have the General Secretariat, 9 Directorates General, 17 Regional Directorates, 12 national and competence centers, and among them the institute I'm director. 10 local superintendents scattered on all the territory. But also the ministry directly manages a lot of institutions, libraries, museums, archives, archaeological sites. You can see more than 1,500, among them 400 museums, the most important national museums, scattered on all the territory, and personal staff, about 19,000 personal staff. MIBAC policy on digital cultural heritage, because my presentation is mainly focused, of course, in digital cultural heritage. Digitization of cultural heritage based on common European standards. Improve the visibility of GLAM, gallery, libraries, archives, museums on the web. Improve content interoperability between national and European portals and websites and systems. And reuse of content for fostering creative industries in the field of education and tourism. What is Cultura Italia? I start presentation presenting you National Aggregator System that aggregates content from all kinds of institutions, museums, libraries, archives, depending not only by the ministry, but also regions, private, local, and so on. And so Cultura Italia is the Italian national aggregator, cross-domain, as I said, more than 2,400,000 metadata, because Cultura Italia aggregates metadata and refers, metadata that refers to the institutions that produced and hold the digital content. The main record Cultura Italia sent 550,000 metadata to Europeana, and in fact we work in very close cooperation with Europeana. The content, you can see the majority of content come from museums, but we also have libraries and archives. We have institutions of the depending of the ministry, but also Italian regions, private, and so on. What are the way to send data to Cultura Italia? Via OAI PMH, but also via a content management system, museo and web that I will present to you in some minutes. We have also in Cultura Italia a pilot session dedicated. We in fact published a set of data coming from Cultura Italia in linked open data, and you can see our basis was CDOC, the data model was CDOC CRM, and the data are linked to VIAF, GeoNames, Pico Thesaurus, which is the thesaurus developed for Cultura Italia, and SCOS, and so on. And this is the picture illustrating, in fact, the national strategy, just to give visibility to the museums, to the institutions on the web. So we have Cultura Italia, which is the national aggregator, that receives metadata from different institutions, different other thematic aggregators. You can see Internet Culturale, which is a thematic aggregators for libraries, but also SAN, thematic aggregation for archives, and Musei d'Italia, thematic aggregation for museums. But also we receive, Cultura Italia receives content from regional aggregators, private archives, universities, and Cultura Italia is the main Italian provider to Europeana. I imagine that you know well, you know what Europeana is the European Digital Library, but in fact is a portal, is an aggregator, is at European level with about 30 million of records, metadata coming from 2,200 European institutions. And we, in fact, work in close cooperation with Europeana. In a very briefly, I present to you one of the thematic aggregators I mentioned in the previous slide, which is Internet Culturale, the aggregator for Italian libraries. Just to show you the data we aggregate in Cultura Italia, in internet culturale, sorry, digital library of Italian libraries. We have about 1 million of records referring to 10 million of files, but we also give an integrated access not only to digital library but also to the catalogs, so the SBN OPAC catalog, but also other database managed by ICCU. But I would like to focus my presentation on the aggregator, national aggregator of musei d'Italia, a portal for Italian museums. We started this project in 2010. The project lasts 3 years. And now we have the Musei d'Italia, which is a section of Cultura Italia. And what contains Musei d'Italia? Mainly two objects. One is a national registry of museums, monuments and archaeological parks. We have a description of 3,800 museums, parks, archaeological sites, and so on. Interoperable, and this instrument is interoperable with all regional database and links to their websites. So we developed this project in cooperation with all the Italian regions, because it is very important, this kind of cooperation. The cultural heritage in Italy is on the territory. This is the characteristic of our cultural heritage, to be patrimony scattered on the territory. And a digital library based on Fedora Commons that contains 300 museums participated in this project, and the digital library contains 650 collection referring to 95,000 objects, digital objects, high resolution. So in this slide you can see what is our strategy. We have two different approach, top-down and bottom-up. So we encourage institutions, of course, in having their website. So we can see in this slide the website of Tondo Doni is present in, of course, website of Uffizi, but also you can see Tondo Doni in Musei d'Italia, in Cultura Italia, and in Europeana. So it's a chain of visibility, starting from the website of the institutions, and thematic aggregator, national aggregator, European aggregator. It is important, given that we manage an aggregator, national aggregator, to have agreements with the content provider. And we base our agreement for metadata, because Cultura Italia and the aggregators, national aggregators and the European aggregators, works with metadata. So we have an agreement with the content provider, and it is important that Culture we accept metadata in CC0, licensed in CC0, but also we also accept metadata not licensed in CC0. And each provider holds the rights on the digital objects, of course. Practical tools. Content management system, museo and web, I mentioned before. In fact, we developed this content management system based on European standards and guidelines and the recommendation developed within Minerva project, which is a project 10 years ago. We managed it 10 years ago. And in fact, CMS and Museum Web is an open source content management system, easy to use, customized for cultural institutions, free of charge. So we offer this service to all the institutions, museums, but also libraries and archives that are interested in creating their website. And we also support them with the tutorials, training courses, and so on. And in fact, we have so far realized 250 websites of different institutions, because we have also customized also for libraries and for archives this instrument that was born in the previous step for museums. Through this content management system you can also send metadata to Cultura Italia and to Europeana. So Museo and the web is interoperable with Cultura Italia and Europeana. Another practical tool that we realized and performed is Movio, a kit to build online and mobile digital exhibition. And during the lunch time, there will be a presentation on this tool. In any case, it is important underline that this project is coordinated by my institute, ECCU, is funded by Fondazione Telecom Italia, developed by Gruppo Meta, and it is also an example of a public-private partnership. Movio was designed to build a digital exhibition. It aims at enabling gallery, library, museums, archive to highlight masterpieces of their collection, as well as less known or not visible work of arts. And the first the presentation of this tools of instrument will be in Rome, 19th of March, and the first trainings will be organized also in Rome the day after. So you are invited to participate in this event. Movio is a kit, an open source for creation of online virtual exhibition. We have also produced tutorials, and we are planned also to organize some training courses devoted to the institution that want to use this tool. And another topic. In line with the Italian national strategy, European projects. You can see in this slide a lot of European projects. On the left side, you can see projects managed by ECCU, and the other side, project where ECCU, our institute, is partner. And more than the new Europeana Sounds, Ambrosia, and so on. But I would like to focus my presentation in the last project that we are coordinating, Athena Plus. Athena Plus, a network of European museums. We have a very large consortium, 40 partners from 21 member states, mainly ministries and governmental agencies, galleries, museums, archives, aggregators, research centers as partners, and also small and medium enterprise. The main goal, this is a best practice aimed to contribute 3,600,000 data to Europeana, the main activities. 80% of the institutions participating are museums. We have about 500 institutions across Europe participating in this project, but the project the concerns also with other activities for museums community. In fact, we are developing a terminology management platform a registry of terminology for cultural heritage sector. And we, in our plan, is also to upgrade Movio, the software produced in Italy, upgrading with innovative tools for education and tourism. What next? What are the main issues that we have to face in near future, also medium? Improve data quality and provide direct access to content so that the user experience can drastically improve. Develop a more explicit value proposition for cultural institutions. They need to be motivated intrinsically to give their best. Creation of new competences in digital cultural heritage and of new opportunities for job. Play a key role in encouraging entrepreneurship in the cultural sector and, main aim, reuse and discoverability of digital cultural aid. So we now we have a great amount of digital content, cultural content. We have to see in our future to use and to reuse this content in order to foster discoverability, to foster creative industry, to foster application for tourism and education. And in fact, these are the topics, the main topics of the Italian presidency of the European Union. What are the messages that we want to launch with our presidency? First of all, policy on digital cultural heritage. The digitization and online access to cultural heritage represent a strong opportunity to foster, as I said, the creative industries and the job creation through the reuse of the digital resources. Our institutional works, in fact, is to foster, to encourage, and to help this kind of reuse. The presidency supports, of course, the development of Europeana, but also the development of national aggregators, thematic aggregators, and websites that play a fundamental role in ensuring core quality content of the European portal, the national aggregators, I mean. But there is also another important line, which is research in digital cultural heritage. And in this field, the Italian presidency will foster and pursue the harmonization of national research program in the field of cultural heritage through the involvement of all stakeholders, researchers, cultural heritage experts, and infrastructure providers. It is very important to foster this kind of cooperation between cultural institutions, research infrastructure, and e-infrastructures, the e-infrastructure that provide services for the institutions. The cultural institutions need to benefit from e-infrastructure providers, this kind of services, storage, connectivity, preservation, because we have a big amount, we have created a big amount of cultural content, but we need also to manage to storage and to preserve and to make this content available and free accessible. And so, according to these two lines, so to foster digitization, reuse of digitization, and to follow also this very important line, the research in digital cultural heritage, infrastructure in digital cultural heritage, we are organizing two international conferences that are in the official program of the presidency. One is 2nd of October in Rome an international conference on the reuse of digital cultural content in education, tourism and leisure, organized in collaboration with Europeana. And the second one is devoted to the second line that I presented. 13th and 14th of November, an international conference on e-infrastructure and research infrastructure for digital cultural heritage in the framework of EIRG, which is international reflective group on e-infrastructure, and in cooperation with Ariadne Project, the project mentioned before, which is very chaired by Franco Nicolucci, from PIN, and who is a partner of this important project. And this conference will be organized in cooperation with Ariadne Project. So, all of you, of course, are invited to participate in these two conferences that will take place in Rome at the National Library in Rome. And finally, some pictures, interesting pictures, representing Uffizi, but also Rome, Palazzo Altemps, Florence and Rome, and Naples. So these are images coming from Musei d'Italia, the portal that I presented to you before. Thank you very much.